Ooh, okay, okay. Y'all see what time it is. We are still back. All right, we're back for part two. Bam, this camera is still recording everything. By the way, big shout outs to everybody viewing. Everybody watching the full length. All right, I know I took a little bit of time to drink some Powerade, drink some water. You know, I was trying to pull up the basically a couple of events that will be going on for the rest of the semester, or you know, in I guess what, the week or two that we come back. But let me go ahead and turn the camera around.
You was never really rooting for me anyway. When I'm back up at the top, I wanna hear you say.
Okay, big shout outs again. Big shout outs to Lil Nas X and Jack Harlow for that song, bro.
Couple number one.
Oh, hold on, hold on. No, come on. I'm trying to get this displayed.
Yeah, hey. Only do it. New shit.
Oh, come on. Please, don't mess it.
But the hood call me Doobie, yeah.
No, come on. Don't do me like this, TV. I need you. Or not TV. It's really my damn laptop. Hold up, bro. Fuck this shit.
I got what they waiting for.
Hold up, y'all. My fault. Technical difficulty. I'm gonna do this shit right here. Ooh, hold up. Let me go ahead. I'm glad that my motherfucking laptop is out here acting a fool. Right? Because I got multiple, and you know what? We gonna go ahead and we gonna get this popping. Now we got it on the big screen.
Yeah.
Oh, come on, where is it? Oh, okay, so
clean. They couldn't wait to just bash me. I must be getting too flashy. Y'all shouldn't have let work ask me. It's too late because I'm here staying. These girls know that I'm nasty. I sent it back to her boyfriend with my
okay, we good. We Gucci. Okay. Oh, wow. The camera's already set up. All right, man. All right, we coming back for part two. Thank you so much. All right, my people on the podcast kingdoms for joining me. Thank you so much, my people on YouTube, for being patient. Also, thank everybody for being patient. All right. Of course, man. You know, I'm still drinking my little water.
Boom.
I'm still pulling up the event. I'm not. I have it right here, but man, I just try to take my time with things, bro. I try to enjoy.
All up from nothing, dog. Get your soul. Just tell him ain't laying low. You was never really rooting for me anyway. When I'm back up at the top, I wanna hear you say.
Okay, cool. I'ma let Lil Nas take it. I'ma let the rest of the song play, cause this shit is mad dope, bro. It's one of them bangers that came out of the summer.
I'm in the street, baby. Yeah. I'm in the street, baby.
Okay. But anyway, all right. So far, we just got through, what's it called? We actually finished up the short response, not short response, the warm topics, the warm questions, all right? And we are about to move on to the hot topics, but before we do that, I just have to give a big shout out. Oh no, come on, don't do me like that. Big shout outs to the Asian American Student Union here on campus. All right, because one, I actually pulled up. They had the their. Hold on, let me cut this volume down. Okay. Want some ice on my wrist so I look better when I dance. Okay, but anyway, they actually had their AASU, by the way, those are their initials, by the way, for anybody who didn't know. they had their initials, not initials, their week, their fall week, not too long ago, and I was fortunate enough to go to one of their events, the night market, and that was pretty awesome. Now, unfortunately, I did not go to it, I wasn't able to make it to more of their events, but listen, man, they AASU and all the affiliates, they still are wilding out. They still doing their thing. Big shout outs to them. And actually, they have an event coming up on November 29th, 2021. Of course, this year, November 29th, all right, when we come back from Thanksgiving break at 6:30 p.m., HCB 102, they have the Native American Heritage Month celebration, all right? Again, that is on November 29th, all right, 6:30, HCB 102, all right? Y'all make sure that y'all pull up, y'all show love. Also, y'all also go to, what's it called, No Central, I believe that's nocentral.dsa.fsu. .edu? Nah, okay. Just type up FSU No Central. I don't know if I got the URL correct. But just go on No Central, search up Asian American Student Union, and make sure that you RSVP for this particular event, all right? And also, they have another one as well. This one, again, it's What's the Tea Social, all right? They got a fucking Tea Social, and you know, hey, listen, I already RSVP'd, all right? So y'all will be able to see me in person, all right, should y'all pull up. But this Tea Social, it is on Thursday, December the 2nd at 5:30, all right? That will be in SSB 214, all right? Again, the What's the Tea Social hosted by the Asian American Student Union, all right, on December the 2nd, 5:30 p.m. at SSB 214, all right? Y'all make sure that y'all RSVP on No Central, all right? And yo, y'all make sure that y'all pull up and show love, man. Shoot, hey, yo, bro, listen, the HLSU, BSU, bro, all these organizations are fucking wilding when it comes to these events. Don't fucking miss out. No one miss out, all right? Yo, I ain't gonna hold you. I feel like this camera look mad fucking clean, though. Oh, yo, I'm really fucking with the flashlight. I'm really fucking with it. It's a roly-roly. I'm about to fuck up the lyrics, but you know what? It's cool. Not your business, not on me. Okay, I still fucked up the lyrics. Okay, cool. Enough with all that. Let's go ahead and get to the hot stuff. All right, just before my freaking camera right here decides that it wants to cut off on me, because I've already took up a whole bunch of time. All right, but let me go ahead. No, you have got to be kidding me. Oh my fuck. Wow, y'all, I am so disappointed. This camera was supposed to catch everything. All right, you guys, we are back. This is part two. I am so pissed. I think I'm gonna have to, whatever footage is recorded from this laptop, I'm gonna just call Double XL, the extra edition, because it's caught most of everything. It's caught everything. But what pisses me off is that I accidentally... I don't even know. I accidentally hit the pad and it stopped. It fucking stopped the footage. It's all cool, y'all. It's all cool. We still here. But let's go ahead and get on to the hot topic, though. All right. Thank everybody so much just for pulling up, showing love, and, you know, just sitting here and having this conversation with me. All right. But the next question, or, you know, the hot topic, rather, I'm actually going to put it on the big screen. Let's go ahead and... Come on. Yo, what the fuck? I swear. I can't stand computers. Ooh. And... hold up. Come on, bro. It's acting really freaking slow. You know what? Hold up, y'all. I'ma find a way around it. Hold up, cause I'm honestly not trying to deal with all this bullshit. It's going too slow for me. It's lagging like hell. Oh. Okay, now we got it. Okay, thank you. Thank you so much. All right. The hot topic that I have for this particular time, right, is the first one. Oh, I have two of them, as I've mentioned earlier. The first one is something that I titled it Superman is Back. Alright, Superman is back, and the official title is Cam Newton giving out 50 tickets in Carolina return. We need to reclaim Bank of America Stadium. Alright, and this comes from a news article writer by the name of Adam Maya from NFL News. So big shout outs to Adam and big shout outs to NFL News. Alright, or NFL.com. All right, and I ended up picking up a couple quotes. All right, you guys, again, feel free to go and check out the article. Bro, what in the, I can never stop knocking stuff over. But yeah, feel free to go and check out the article. Again, the article is Cam Newton giving out 50 tickets in Carolina return. We need to reclaim Bank of America Stadium, and the article is on NFL.com, all right? And this was an article about basically Cam Newton's awesome return back to Carolina, all right? And this is, of course, this is after freaking there was a coach change, and the head coach fucked around, did something. I'm not gonna lie, I thought this was a bad choice, but he stupidly got rid of Cam Newton, and then Cam went to the Patriots, and you know, he played from what I heard, he played good on the Patriots, and then Bill Belichick ended up cutting him, and then bam, Cam Newton ended up finding his way for whatever reason back to Carolina. And also major props and you know what, a thank God for that. All right, thank God, and I'm happy for Cam, and I'm happy for the Carolina Panthers. The quote that I ended up picking up, or the first quote rather, I'm gonna read all of them, by the way. The first quote states, Cam Newton entered his press conference wearing a fedora with a full press pass reading Clark Kent attached to it. His t-shirt featured an illustration of himself screaming, accompanied with the caption, I'm back. Only the first word was crossed out and printed above it. Right? I don't quite know why the hell they... My fault, y'all. I don't know why the fuck Adam decided to freaking take the long way around to saying, basically his shirt said, we're back. I don't know what the fuck. All right, but anyway, big shout outs to you, Adam. But another quote was, 1 week after rejoining the franchise he long starred with, the former MVP is doing his part to pay it forward. He announced his plan to give away 50 tickets to Sunday's home game against the Washington football team, to people who otherwise don't have the opportunity to attend Panthers games. Newton said the idea emanated from a conversation he was having with his cousin just recently, and incidentally about what he'd do differently if he had the chance to return to Charlotte. Another quote, he stated, simple and plain, I only know one Bank of America Stadium, so with that being said, this is a challenge for people to make my kind of prophecy correct, Newton explained. I said there's no other place in football that I would rather be on Sunday than the Bank of America Stadium, because it would be a playoff atmosphere for more ways than one. Discredit who I am and what this game means to me. Discredit who we're playing and what the game means to them. Let's get back to getting that edge and bringing the pride back to Carolina, how I once knew it to be. Okay. And of course, I didn't quite have any, what's it called, any like specialized questions off of this outside of like what are the thoughts regarding the quotes. Oh yeah, and also you guys make sure that you check out the article, because I remember the article ended off on basically talking about the matchup between, because Ron Rivera coaches the Washington football team, and so now basically you got a reunion, and Cam just happened to come back to the Carolina Panthers. So bam, there you have that reunion there. What's to be said? Again, outside of that, I've already expressed how I believe, well, basically how I'm happy that Cam Newton ended up going back. I gotta say this, Cam, I've sort of kind of fell out of touch when it comes to football and basically keeping up on it. But like Cam Newton, especially like during his Auburn days and his earlier NFL careers, I loved Cam Newton. I absolutely loved Cam Newton. He was my favorite quarterback. I'm not gonna lie. He's not my favorite quarterback. As of now, he's my all-time favorite quarterback. But my favorite quarterback at the moment is between Patrick Mahomes and Lamar Jackson. They've got that title for now. But overall, Cam Newton, he's my favorite quarterback. Like I remember, I was in the fifth grade, this is very vivid. I was in the fourth grade. I had gotten in trouble because I was fucking up with regard to grades, and I was staying up late doing homework, and my youngest brother's dad happened to have the game on of basically the Auburn Tigers versus the Oregon Ducks, that national BCS game. And I remember I was watching it, and I followed Cam Newton, throughout the season. Like, he was, I remember I saw his highlight video. Like, there's this one Auburn highlight video that he has, and the music's playing All of the Above, and I just felt like it just went all together. Like, he's bringing to Carolina, like we saw it. Well, one, we saw it before he fucking left. And again, I'm gonna say this again, I don't know all the specific details. I don't know who the fuck the head coach is, but I'm not gonna lie. And I don't mean to be critical or that, but that was a fucking stupid, dumbass decision to let him go to begin with. That was fucking whatever. That stupid, and I'm not gonna. I don't know. I think I'm speaking off of I'm speaking off of emotion. Although from like when, like if I were to go off of the information that I heard, is also it's not a. I'd be somewhat supported by the information that I've heard, but. But yeah, no, that wasn't it. I don't feel like that was the move. And not only that, Cam Newton, he can still play ball. So, you know, but wow, just like that, I lost my train of thought. I'll respond to the question, or respond to the quotes directly. But I'll also again just let me just reiterate again. I guess how happy I am to see him there. Again, because he used to, bro, I remember, like, whenever I used to play sandlot football often, right, I was so in love with Cam. Like, every time I'd score a touchdown, I'd always do the Superman little celebration and all that other sort of jazz. And I remember me and my homeboy, big shout-outs to Matthew Gunderson, man, big shout-outs to him, because he was a big Colin Kaepernick fan. And he was always like, yo, Colin Kaepernick is a way better quarterback than Cam Newton. And I was like, nah, no, he's not. And every time he'd score, and then not only that though, what made it fucking, it sucked because it was the one playoff game, the 49ers versus the Panthers. This was when the 49ers was really fucking good. they were really good. This was like the year after they went to the Super Bowl but lost to the Ravens. they ended up going up to, no, Carolina ended up coming to the 49ers, and Colin Kaepernick scored, and they won, the 49ers won the game, and, like, Kaepernick, he did the celebration. He was like, Superman, zip it up, and then did his celebration. That was fucking, I was mad as hell when he did that, but nonetheless, though, that shit was wrong, but... And not only that, because me and my boy Matt, we would freaking, bro, listen, that was our clash, and he would just, every time he scored, he'd zip, oh, come on, every time, my crown keeps falling off, but he would, and he'd zip up the freaking soup thingy and all that, and whenever I'd score, like, I'd like go as if I'm going to kiss my arm. I'd be like, take that shit off, Superman. Yo, I love it, man. I love it. So, it's just when I think of Cam, I just think a whole bunch of memories that for what I talked about. Of course, they're somewhat connected to him, but they also are a little distant, all right? But nonetheless, though, he's had an influence. He's had somewhat of an influence on me, all right. And I don't quite know if they're gonna, cause the one of the last times that Cam Newton was there, and this is something bomb as well, cause I'm talking about Cam Newton during his like earlier years in the NFL. But there came a period in time where Cam and the Panthers were red fucking hot. They were like on fire, even more so than. They were like on fire even more so than the first years that Cam was in the league. They stormed through the NFC and made it to the Super Bowl, and unfortunately those Broncos was on one when they got to the Panthers, bro. The defense more than anything, they was on one, bro. And I was mad as fuck when Cam didn't, because bro. And one, I was mad as fuck that they lost to the fucking Falcons. I think they lost to the Falcons twice that year. I think it was either they lost to the Falcons twice that year, and well, either that or they lost the last two games of the season, and they could have went like 16-17-0, and then not only that, but ugh, fuck, it's just it's. When you do so much winning in a season, bro, like, I'm not gonna lie, I don't know the last time I can recall I'll say a 15-1, a 14-2, a 13-3 team winning. I think you maybe 13-3 might be pushing it. It's got to be like a 12-6, 10-something sort of. And like, just going off of statistics, this doesn't even happen. I totally done went off kilter when it comes to the quotes. But just speaking football, like, I think I would trust the team to win a Super Bowl if they happen to, like, if they got like a 12-6 sort of kind of record, like an 12-5 or 12-6, 11-5, 11-6, like 10-6, 10-7, like something like that. I think I trust that, because they have, of course, as indicated by their record, they've won games and they've lost games. So they know how to lose games and they know how to win games. So I think I would trust them better to like make it to the Super Bowl than a team that has won to make it to the Super Bowl and win than just a team that has been doing a whole lot of winning, because at some point in time they're going, like, it's inevitable that they're going to come across, somebody's going to bust them in the fucking mouth. It's football, bro. Somebody's going to bust you in the mouth, and not only that, like, you won't get caught slipping, and you're going to lose a game. Everybody loses a game. Everybody, right? And but nonetheless, though, but when Cam, bro, this was the dab. This was the hit the folks. This is like, oh, hit the folks sort of kind of thing, right? So, and you know what? I want to see that same energy, man, because that was also pretty, like, again, the earlier years was really something, right? But that was like a whole nother level. I felt like that was, I'm not gonna say that was Showtime Panthers, but like that was swaggy. That was them swaggy Carolina boys, man. They was fucking wildin'. They was wildin'. And I hope that they basically my thoughts on that, like, one, it seemed like, yo, Cam is really like, bro, he might fuck around and, although he hasn't brought a ring, he might fuck around and be somewhat similar, like how LeBron is for Cleveland. He might be that, or D-Wade is for Miami. He might be that for Charlotte. So I think they need to hold on to him. And two, I hope that they get. Fuck, I don't know if they're gonna win. They got a good team, but I don't know if they're gonna make it to the Super Bowl and win. But I just wish them the absolute best, and I wish that they're able to return to where they to the level and I guess the degree to which they were once at within, especially within that Super Bowl year, if not surpass that. That's basically my thoughts on that. But let me see how much time I have on the camera. Are you kidding me, bro? You've got to be shitting me, bro. That's the, come on, man. It freaking did it again, y'all. It did it again. I'm not gonna say it did it. Fuck, bro. It's just, okay, y'all. Take three again. I'm getting tired of this. I don't know what, I think it's because my phone is on. It was on one of the buttons, and it ended up cutting the foot. This shit sucks. I'm still gonna post all the content. All right. Fuck, man. Fuck. Okay, it's cool. It's cool, y'all. It's cool. Oh, wow. But anyway, right? And we will go ahead and move on to the second topic. The second topic that we have is, it's something that I've titled No Vulnerability for the Strong. Right, but the official title for the article is Chance the Rapper Unpacks Why Black Men Are So Guarded About Their Emotions. All right, and this particular source comes from Kanyla Phillips from NBC News. One big shout out to Kanyla and big shout out to NBC News. And of course, you know, we got a couple quotes. And you know, actually, the first quote, one, not a couple, I remember this one. I have 7 quotes for this from this one. Y'all definitely should check out the article. I try not to get the entire thing. But in me doing that, what ends up happening is that I end up like picking out like most of the article. Just because I feel like whatever it is that I pick is like, these are critical and, you know, important information, all right? But let me go ahead and read the article, or not read the article, let me go ahead and read out the quotes that I picked out for you guys, all right? The first quote is like, you know, a summation of basically the content. On the latest episode of Facebook's Watch, On the latest episode of Facebook Watch's Peace of Mind with Taraji, actor Taraji P. Henson, co-host Tracy Jade, and recording artist and activist Chance the Rapper discussed the stigma surrounding mental health around black men. All right. And another quote, trust is probably the number one reason why specifically African Americans do not go to therapy, said Jade, the executive director of the Boris Lawrence Henson Foundation, which advocates for mental health care. It takes a lot to trust you with our information, right? Another quote, only 26.4% of black and Hispanic men ages 18 to 44 who experience mental health challenges actually seek treatment. The American Psychology Association noted, Wow. Okay, I totally could have read that better. Of the black men who do try counseling, those who prefer